Hello, musicians. Thank you for joining us. My name is Andrew Mercer, and this is part two of our spooky soundscape tutorial. Now, it's also part of our whole spooky sound series, which you can check out in my channel. Now, in the last tutorial, you learned how to find sound samples on soundbible.com, and you learned how to download them to your computer. Now, as you can see here in my downloads folder, I've got loads of samples that I want to use for my soundscape. And you notice that they're all WAV files. You can also use MP3s, but they won't be as good a quality. Check out the video right here on the difference between WAV files and MP3 files. Very important. Okay, now what I'm going to show in this one is how to get these sound samples into Audacity and get set up to start editing. Pretty easy stuff. So what I'm going to do is, I've got all these right here. I'm going to select them all. You can do it by holding your mouse down and sliding up over all the samples. And then I'm going to grab the samples, all of them, at the same time, and I'm going to bring them over to Audacity into an area that's just gray, that's not being used, and let it go. Now look at that. It opened up all the samples for us. So now, but you can't see them. They're scrolled, they're all over the place, and like they're all different samples. So we need to find a way to see all these on the screen at the same time. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up to View, and we're going to go down to Fit Vertically. Okay, fit vertically. And click that, and look at that. It puts all of our samples vertically so we can see them. And I have got cat scream, cellar door, footsteps, psycho, speaking, you know, all on and on. So you can see those. Now, the other thing I want to be able to do is I need you to be able to use these tools over here, our magnifying glass tools. You may want to zoom in from time to time like this, and you may want to zoom out from time to time to see the bigger picture. Okay, so you need to learn to use those, and use those a lot. Also, we also have a couple other ones here, like Fit Project. If you do that one, it will just fit it into the maximum screen. And if you select a portion, like let's say if you wanted to only have this much on the screen, a portion that you select with your mouse, you can click this one right here, which says Fit Selection, and it will only fit the selection to the screen. So get used to using those. Now, another thing too is, if the names over here, if they haven't been named properly, like if they don't have a name that you recognize quickly, then you want to rename these. And if you click here, you can do that by going to name, and you can rename the track. Okay, and that way you'll be able to know what you're seeing. Like I know this is footstep. I know that this is cellar door because it's written here. So you may need to rename those. Okay, that's pretty easy to do. Now, that's it for tutorial number two in this series. Come back for the next tutorial, number three in the spooky soundscape, and we will learn how to edit these samples to build your soundscape. Okay, so come right back.